Welcome back, PC World fans. Keith here for another weekly roundup of some of the biggest news in the world of PCs. Now, this week we've got quite a variety of topics, so if you thought this was a bit of a quiet week, then hold on to your pants, because we've got the official launch of the AMD Ryzen 5000 G Series APUs to the DIY market, Corsair sheds some light on the DDR5 thermal expectations, Ethereum finally experiences changes that should hopefully free up GPUs for gamers, and a big old nothing burger from a 3DFX tease. Now that's quite a bit to cover, so let's jump right in. Well, we haven't had a good old DIY launch of AMD's APU lineup since the Ryzen 3000G series with the Ryzen 3 3200G and the Ryzen 5 3400G. Now that officially changes this week with the launch of the Ryzen 5 5600G and the Ryzen 7 5700G, and it couldn't have come at a more better time. Well, maybe 6 months ago would have been an even better time, but now is good too. The premise behind the Ryzen with Radeon graphics chips is simple. Combine modern higher performance CPU cores, Zen 3 in this case, with a powerful discrete level GPU performance, well, still Vega for those wondering, into a single package without the requirement of a dedicated graphics card. Now let me run through the specifications of the two chips that are releasing to the DIY market, starting with the Ryzen 7 5700G. For this part, we're looking at an 8-core, 16-thread chip based on the 7-nanometer Zen 3 architecture with a boost clock up to 4.6 GHz, and it's paired with 8 CUs of Radeon graphics at 2 GHz, 24 lanes of PCIe Gen 3.0, and 20 megabytes of cache, all on its 65-watt TDP for an MSRP of $359. Now the other chip in the lineup is the Ryzen 5 5600G. It's also based on the 7-nanometer Zen 3 architecture, but this time cutting things back to 6 cores and 12 threads with a boost clock of 4.4 GHz. The GPU side is trimmed back as well to 7 CUs at 1.9 GHz, but you still get 24 lanes of PCIe Gen 3.0 with a slightly cut 19 megabytes of cache while still remaining at that 65-watt TDP, and this one clocks in at $259, about $100 cheaper than the 5700G, but looks to still be a very strong part. Now, Gordon worked with Sebastian Schinzinger from our sister site, PC Velt, to get testing numbers for an article on PC World, which is linked below. And among plenty of benchmarks, this testing shows the Ryzen 7 5700G is able to drive 1080p esports titles much better than the older Ryzen 5 3400G, and even better than Intel's latest UHD graphics. Now, Gordon goes into how AMD is getting so much more out of this 5000 series APU in the article, so it's a highly recommended read. And if you're looking for a pre-built packing one of these new chips, Elena has you covered in an article on her recommendations for the best options. But we all know that APUs perform better with faster memory, and in the future, things could get even more interesting with the upcoming launch of DDR5. Now, it turns out that DDR5 future could be quite a bit hotter than we're used to seeing with DDR4, and I'm not just talking about the market expectations. In recent marketing video, Corsair brings up the idea that DDR5 could conceivably run much hotter than DDR4. Now, some people might find this a bit odd because over the years, as DDR technology has developed, we've seen a reduction in voltage required, resulting in lower thermals. But with DDR5, there's a big shift on how that voltage is regulated. See, voltage regulation is no longer going to be handled on the motherboard, but will instead be done on the modules themselves, and that could easily increase the operating temperatures of these modules. Of course, Corsair does take this opportunity to market their patented dual-path heat exchange, or DHX technology, and we'll have to see how well that performs against its competitors when available. Honestly, the voltage regulations moving to the DIMMs, as well as the ludicrously high operating speeds of DDR5, I do expect that almost all modules will be shipping with some sort of heatsink. There will be exceptions, of course. Now, sorry I don't have a good segue to this topic, but it might come across as a bit odd to be discussing cryptocurrency mining here, but there's a really good reason for it, and I want to bring attention to the full implementation of Ethereum's EIP 1559 and the London hard fork to my fellow PC enthusiasts. Now, I'm going to keep this topic quite high level, but there is a more detailed explanation linked in the description for those wanting to dive a bit deeper. So with the Ethereum Improvement Proposal 1559, this proposal will heavily impact the profitability of Ethereum due to the changes in the gas fees as well as miner tips. Now, this will likely be felt hardest by mid to smaller mining operations, as we've already seen quite a drop in mining profitability for Ethereum as it continues to march towards its proof of stake, leaving proof of work behind it. Now, everyone trying to buy a graphics card over the past year knows that the global supply chain issues, along with increased Ethereum mining, has led to problems with GPUs getting in the hands of gamers. Well, if the impact of EIP 1559 is great enough, and many of these people aren't seeing the returns they once were, the likelihood of them going back to the store shelves for more cards will be much lower. Now, this will hopefully leave an opening for gamers to finally get first dibs on the cards they've been holding out so long for. Now, the long wait for GPU stock has spurred lots of hope and enthusiasm for a company to come into the market and save them. And I'm not exactly talking about Intel Xe here. There was a very short-lived internet troll who took that opportunity to play an extremely weak attempt at pulling nostalgic heartstrings of PC gamers. They started an 3D Effects official Twitter account claiming the return of the once king of PC graphics. Those of us who have been around long enough knew this was unlikely, but many were hopeful. Alas, as many of us were still quite certain, it was indeed a hoax. Whoever created this account has since moved on, so let's put the nail in that coffin and move on as well. And with that one put under the dirt, let's wrap up the real news. We have the official launch of AMD's Ryzen 5000 G-Series APUs for a good starter system or a small form factor build. Corsair sheds light on the possibility of DDR5 running a bit hotter than what we're used to, and EIP 1559 is Ethereum's next step in moving away from proof of work, which should limit its attractiveness to GPU miners and leave more for PC gamers who have been holding out. Now, if you enjoyed this week's roundup, make sure you hit that thumbs up button and make sure you're subscribed to PC World for more PC hardware and software goodness in the future.